Hey guys, so I edited a companion and the options, the custom primitives, and as you can see, I added some options. You can, with shift, add more than one, and you can activate a boolean, and if you activate a robool, you will automatically have a boolean. You will be able to change all of this, okay? So, this is interesting. What I will do is to make a little asset. It's not my strength to make such asset like I will do, but you will see the potential of the options. I will just move this a little here. So I will press this. I will scale this. I will call the bevel. I will have my bevel. I will be able to play with the settings. Space solidify S to play with the thickness. Pretty simple. Space bevel, shift space to add a new one, shift space to add a new one. So as you can see, this is pretty simple. I can press tab to go in edit mode and edit my object as I want. Just like that, tab. So I can exit, just like that. What I will do is click on cursor, mirror, I will choose X, Y, and Z. Just to show you, I will use boolean on this one. I will press shift and click, and that will place my cursor here directly like that. As you can see, the cursor uses the geometry, so it's up to you to edit it in the preferences to choose the geometry by default. So I will select this one, no, this one. I will press alt and I will click. That will give me this result, okay? I will press RZ90. And I will have this result. Like that, I will be able to edit this one and to move it. I can even scale it if I want. Just like that. Play with the solidify. To move it, to have something like that. I can even, on this one, add a bevel. So, shift space. And that will add a little bevel like that. So, if I see the result, I will have this. Okay? So, as you can see here, I need to go in edit mode. And maybe, yes, move this one. I will just move it a little, like that. I will exit the edit mode, and that's it. So, I will hide this. Maybe I should hide this one to show you all of this. I will just click here and have this result. I can move it as I want. I have my object selected. I will use this one, alt and click. That will scale it, just like that. As you can see, this is... This is fast and easy, and since I'm using X, Y, and Z, I have the same result everywhere. So what I can do on this one is maybe duplicate it, call companion and shift on the display, that will give me this. So I have here a solidify, a displace, etc. So I can make something like that, space bevel, I will decrease it like that, shift space, and I will have this result. I can play on the displace, or I can go in edit mode, just like that, select everything and move it vertically. Ooh, GZ to have this result. I can even go in edit mode, hopla, tab, press 3, and as you can see, this one is like that, so if I move this, that will give me this result. Boom, if I press 3, I will have this, so this is interesting. I will keep that like that, tab, exit. And that's it. This one I can hide it. And I made this. After, if you want, you can take the cursor and move it. This one that should be in y-axis. Like that. I will move it here. Okay? So I will select this one. I will come back. And I will, why not use this one? Alt and click. That will give me this. I will press, I can go in edit mode. RZ90. And I created this. And the interesting part on this one is that this is a line, and with a solidify I can have this result. Just like that. And if I press tab, I can move it. Just like that. So interesting. Tab, exit. I can hide this one. I can even select this and come here. I will come here. Why not? I will press, I will do the same in fact on this one. I will press alt. Up, and I will have this result. Like that, I like it. I like it. So, I will hide it. You have a lot of options here. So, I will make something, why not here? Why not use and move instead just this one? Like that, I will have something perfect. So, let's come back. I will use this one. Press Alt. Always in the, oops, I forgot to select this one. So, Alt. Yep. And I will have this result. I can go in edit mode. Press SYY. That will give me this. So this is what I want. I can just move this one here. Why not? And I will go in object mode and I will hide it. As simple as that. So if you want, you can call this one by using the boolean. Just like that. Up. Just have to wait because I have a lot of object on this one. I think it's this one. Yes. And on this one, I will go in edit mode. Just like that, and I will move it to have something like that. Why not? Boom. And why not try to hide everything? Boom. And that's it. And I will take Shift RMB. I will make something like that here. I can after move. I will make a smart cursor. I think maybe directly here, or maybe on a speed flow. I don't know, but I have some ideas for this smart cursor. Could be interesting to move it as we want, etc. To have something really nice. So, on this one, what can I do? I will come back here, not here, it was here. So, maybe I could use this one. As you can see, I have some options. Let's try maybe more this one. Boolean, up, Alt. And I will just make this, just like that. So, this one, I can press GYY, I will move it on the Y axis, and after I can, why not, add an array. I will just click to count 2, hopla, S2, D0 to remove the X axis, Y, D, and I will press 2, and it was minus 2, up. Just like that, a little too strong. Up, not too strong. Yes. Up, come back. Blender needs a lot of change in perf. As you can see, this is not correct. But if you look, I'm working on every part of this one. As you can see, the array is after the mirror, so I will just move it. And normally, I will just have to edit again this to have a perfect result. I don't know why it changed the result, but it's not really an issue. So, I have this, and as you can see, I made it on every other part of the object. So, I will press H. And this is just one object. It's not always great to make only one object with a lot of cuts because Blender has a lot of difficulties with this right now. What you can do also is why not to make a cut on this object. So I will make a cut in fact here. So I will select this one. I will press Shift S and cursor to selected. This is not my pie. I need to activate my pie. I will choose Y to 0. And I will remove the rotation like that. Some of these two. So, on this one, I will just come back, and this time I will use a rule. I will remove the Z. I will just choose the X axis to have X axis. And on this one, I will just press Alt, and I will click. And normally I should have my result. Yes, as you can see, I have this. I will just make a rotation, RY90. Yep. And this one I can press scale. That will cut my object, as you can see. And this is not perfect, so what I will do is to add a solidify. And to play with the, oopla, to play with, come back, the offset. To choose the correct axis. So here, hopla, it was the other side in fact. I will come here, up, and I will come here, like that. So I will move it before the mirror, and I will have this result. In fact, now I have two objects, one and two. What you can do on this one is to, why not clean, not with you, clean the modifiers. If you don't need this one, we need it. This one too, and the other one not. So, yes, I need this one, and not and this one. Yes. And like that, you will have something better to work with. Hop, I'll press H. So as you can see, this is not my my cam. This kind of modeling, but we can do it. It's not really an issue. I can also come here. I will show you something. I will activate the cursor, the mirror, the x-axis, and the y-axis with Shift. In fact, if you click, that will be this, and Shift, that will be this. So I will choose the three. I will place my cursor here, and I will press Control and move this one. So that will give me this result, okay? I will go in edit mode, press E, I will activate the X-ray, and I will make something like that. Up. And like that, okay? So if we remove this, we will add a solidify, and you will see the result. I will have this, but as you can see, if I go to this part, this is not what I want. So what I will do is to come on the mirror, and I will press Shift Z, and let's try Control Z, and it wasn't this. Shift Z to activate. In fact, if you activate the bisect, so Shift Z will activate the Z axis, and Control Z will activate the bisect. And it's not always working, as you can see. So let's try with Shift X2 and Shift Y2 and remove the Control Z and remove the Shift Z. Shift Y, Shift X. Yes, I know why. I need to move it after the solidify. So my bad. This is a workflow I just learned. Enfin, not learned, but edited to make it work. So this is not something I have the habit to do. So now I have several objects. I can hide this one. So as you can see. So just to show you again, you need just to have your object, your mirror, after the solidify. If not, you will not have the proper result. Okay. So what I can do is come here. As you can see, I will add yes, I can have this one. I will just add a simple cube and alt up, just like that. And as you can see, this is my result. Okay. So what I can do is go in edit mode, make something like that. I need to go here. And yes, I can make this here, like that. And maybe move it like that. So just maybe move it vertically. Just like that, with an object, you can make some cuts to have this kind of details. So I can continue. I will use this one. Boom. Just like that. I can keep it like that. Press G. And don't forget, right now I'm working on all the side of the object. So. It's not, Blender is not, Blender has a lot of difficulties with this. So, as you can see, could be better. I will press Shift C to place the cursor and maybe move the cursor in Z a little like that. Here, like that. So, I will now, continue and use this one because I like this one. Up, with S, I will make my scale. And what I can do also is move it, just to show you the difference. And because I have the mirror activated, I will have this kind of result. So this is not really what I want, but I can just scale it like that and move it like that. And that will give me this. But if you want, you can also come here and on this one, call the mirror. And press Shift X like that and Control X. That will activate the bisect. You cannot see it, but you have the bisect here. And this is interesting because you can also take everything and move it here. just like that, and press Shift Y and Control Y to revert dbsect, and after continue and just edit this one again, yep, like that, or make a little scale. And this is just one, but with a lot of, with a mirror, etc., etc. So it's up to you to try to make something with that, but it's working. And as you can see, Blender have a lot of difficulties. I will exit. I will hide this one. And this is what we have. And in fact, I forgot. But when you are in a mode. Qu'importe le mode, I will press G to I will press G to activate the loop slide. And if you press 5, you will have this. And as you can see, I have only two objects right now, enfin 3 with this one. And it's hard to have the same result. And I can exit to have this. So this is interesting. And you can why not add some lines. So I will make something. I will come here, I will remove this one, and I will keep this one. So what I will do is press I will do this one, Alt, that will create this. So this is interesting. I will go in edit mode, and it's not what I wanted. I will remove this one. I will restart, and I will use this one in fact. Hop. And normally I should have the result I want. Yes. I will just move it here. Okay, I will take this one, I will move it, hopefully not here, just here. So what I will do is to press Alt D, why not Alt D, and after I will just move this to have this kind of result. So I will press Alt D, up, Alt D, and after I will just move this. And I can activate the snap and just snap here. So just like that, I created this. I can add a bevel. Hopla, I was too fast. Too fast. And after shift space to add the last one. I can edit this screw. Why it's exit each time? I have some difficulties. 64, maybe it's too much, but you can check this result here. So. It seems my mirror have disappeared, so I will press O to select this object, and I will press Y, and I will press Z, and just like that. I will not use Z on this one. Okay, so this is what I have right now. So, I will create a simple vertice. It will be placed here. I will go in edit mode, press EZ, just like that, go in 3. I will just move it, press E, and press E. So what I can do now is to control A in object mode and apply a location. So like that, if I select this one, I will go in items, I will be 0 in X, no, it was in Y, 0 in Y, and like that, as you can see, I will have something something nice. In fact, I could add a mirror in Y, Shift Y, and Control Y to make a merge at the center. And I can apply it just like that and remove this one. So on this one, what I will do is to add a bevel here. Control B V. I will add some segments like that, and I will call the tubify file. So just like that, as you can see, I created this. I will press 2. I will be able to play with the number of segments. I don't need too much hair, but I want more hair. So let's try 12. Hopla. Huh? Yes, it's different. I need to fix, I will fix this one. Yep. Like that. So, as you can see, I created this. I will press 2. I will exit. And I have this one. But it's not really, it's not really nice. I will edit this. I will just move this one. Hopla. Yes. Yep. One by one, in fact. G and X. As you can see, this is reverted. Ha 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 ha. So, I will take this one. I will press G. Because the object is this in this side. If I go here, yep. This object is there. So, I can move it here. Move it here. Move it vertically here. Like that, and this one, I need to select everything, to move it, I will go in front of you, hop, here. And inside, in fact, I need to remove this one. I don't need it. X, up, delete vertices. So, I have this. I can take all of this. Up, since I can in fact remove all of this. I will show you. X, delete vertices. And this is what I have. I can add a mirror in X and Y, like that. I can I have this result. Maybe activate the shade smooth on this one. And why not place the cursor? Yep, I will go in 3 in 1. Why not place the cursor directly correctly placed here? That will give me this result, and in the cursor in Y I will put 0, and like that I will be able to add this one, Alt and click. Up, I will make a rotation, RY, up now, RX 90, I will make a scale, I have a solidify, so I can edit my solidify, I can add a little bevel, just like that, boom, and it's not perfectly placed, but I will fix that, and that's it, so, one, just move it, place it correctly, and that's it. So I can add on this one a mirror in X, and I will press O to select this object as reference. And that's it. Let's try if we come here to see it. So as you can see, interesting. I can continue, in fact, add as many details as I want. Why not add some here? So I will place cursor, mirror, X, Y this time. I will not add it at the bottom. And I will use this one. I like this one with the boolean. So Alt and click. Up. Just have to wait a little. Not too bad. Maybe move it vertically. G to have this here. I will press H. Why not place something here? And why not call the asset management? I should have some up. Not the other one. Not this one. Where is my insert? Yep. Screws and bolts. And let's add something interesting like this one. Yes, I will use this one. Yep. Like this one. So if I scale it, it's not on the cursor. Ooh, this is where it should be in the cursor. Shift S, selection to cursor. Just like that. But I need to add here on this one a little cut. So let's use this one, or maybe yes, I will use this one. I have deselected boolean, Alt and click. Yep. And since it's a lot of subdivisions, yep, it has some difficulties. Yep. I will hide this one Shift S selection to cursor. I will scale it a little. And I will move it. I will add a mirror, press O to select this one, and Y. Yes, it should be in Y. My bad. Mirror, Y. And that's it. So, we have this. It's not the type of modeling I do all times, so I'm really bad at it. But if you can see the interest of all of this, it's nice, because all of this is pretty cool and pretty fast. I like to be to have something fast. Let's add something here. Difference. I will use this one with Alt. Up. Oh, vertically like that. It was interesting. Up. Yes, I like it. I can move it, in fact, to go here. Maybe make something like that, and maybe add an array. I will choose count 2, D0 for the x-axis, y, d, and I will have this. But I need to move the array before the mirror. If I don't, I will not have the result I want. So just like that, I can make this to not have something symmetrical. I will click and I will hide it. And obviously, I have my mirror on the other side. Let's continue. I can add some details on this one. Just like that, I can use this one. I like this one. It's really nice. Just like that, as you can see. Yep. It's fast. So this is interesting. You can do whatever you want. I will press H. I can continue, select this one and call this one. Alt. That will scale it. And it seems GZZ to place it. No, it seems in this one it wasn't correct. So Alt Boolean mirror XY, it's correct, and I will press Alt and click. So normally that should work. Yes, this time it's correct. So GZZ to move it. Yes. It wasn't the one I wanted. Well, it's not really an issue. I will come here. That should do the trick. I will hide it. And I will duplicate this one. Shift D. I will just move it here. Shift S. Oopla. Shift S. Selection to cursor. And I have an options. Copy aligning to cursor. Copy cursor rotation. Yes. So GZZ to move it. And that's it. Yes. I have some other options to on the cursor. I will make something nice. And that's it. So it's not a time lapse. Everything is fine. It's not, I don't cheat because I have a little issue here. If I made a time lapse, you will think it's perfect, but it's never perfect. Up on this one, it seems this is this one. If I move it, up, yes, this is that. And this result is because I have a line here, it seems. And logically, if I come under this, not on this one, up, maybe I can cheat a little to just move it up, as you can see here, or maybe make something the other side. No, I want something at this center, but since I have a line here, it's not perfect. I will keep it like that. H. So, why not add something here? So I will place this cursor here. I will call this one. Yep. Just like that. That will give me this result, okay? So what I will do is to select this one, and add a boolean. Just like that. But I have a lot of cuts on this one. It's not perfect. So that's it. And in fact, what I will do is to duplicate it. Shift D, and I will make something like that. Shift and click. So on this one, what I can do is to add a cut. So I will add a cut. So I will call this one. Up. Just like that, and I will add a solidify, and I will play with the offset. I should have something that work normally before the mirror. Up. Ooh. I know why. I need to remove the mirror on this one. I will remove the mirror. Yes. So my bad. So on this solidify, I will be able, as you can see, to play with it. And after, this is a cut, this one, so I can keep it. But what I will do is to make a mirror, Y. That will cut every part. So like that, I will exit and hide this one. And on this one, I will do this. So on this one, I will add a bevel. Shift space. Up. Ish. I think I have some little issues on this one. So, let's come back. Bevel. I have this. I will remove the number of segments. Up. And I will press Shift Y. And to have this result. And sometimes I have something really weird. Up. Maybe because of the other object. But it was just to show you. I fixed this later. So, this is what we have so far. This is not too bad. I can add some options here. So, Shift C and move the cursor in Y here. Select this one. Up. And let's use this one. So, I will use maybe this one. Use Alt. And it's not rotated. So, I forgot to rotate the object RY90. No. RX90. Oh, I have some issues. Okay, let's restart. Come here, Alt, Control, Alt and click. Ah. Mirror, I will remove the X axis. Nickel. And this one, I will just move it in X to 0. So just like that, I will scale it. I will hide it. And this one, I will add this one. Up. I need to remove the mirror, in fact. My bad. Up. Mirror. X. Just like that. If I don't remove the mirror, I will not have the result I want. And I will just press G. Maybe make it like that. Yes. And we will stop here because I don't know what to do else. And that's it. So, if I come here, I activate the random. Too much details on this one. I should cut instead of making this kind of things. Up, press N.